This is Chanelle Skelley from Toe to Toe. I'm here with Mark Bam Bam Flanagan. How are you doing?
Good. Nice having me.
So you're in the Gold Coast tonight, and they come to cheer on Lee and Paro.
Yeah, come to cheer on Lee and Paro. You know, been a big supporter of his since he was a young teenager. I found him from a club in North Queensland. He's grown to a great fighter, you know, he's undefeated and now he's got the biggest test of him tonight, and everyone's here in great support, for a great fight.
He's been sparring with Jeff Horn lately, hasn't he, obviously? How has he been getting on with that? Has it been good for Jeff and good for...
He's sparring Jeff Horn, Dennis Hogan, he's been sparring all the top guys in their divisions. I think it's beneficial, you know, knowing he's sparring Jeff Horn, and Jeff Horn's style, you know, he's a very very in-your-face kind of style, and for Liam to be sparring, you know, good rounds of world champion and that kind of style, you know, it shows with the level that he's at, and you know, he's ready for this fight 100%.
Brilliant. So what do you think about the Jeff Horn fight with Crawford? How do you think he's going to get on over in Vegas?
I think it's an interesting fight. I think Jeff's in a better chance than a lot of the American people are giving him, you know. Like, it's his style, you know. He's got that broken rhythm boxing, you know, the way he attacks and the way he comes in, you know. He's a hard guy to predict the fight, and Crawford thinks he might have him worked out, but I think he's in for a hard night. I think Jeff can shock the world again, you know.
Brilliant. I like me too.
Yeah.
So have we got any plans for you in the future then? Have you got anything coming up, or have you got any fights that you want to make happen, or...?
Fights coming up, nothing in the pipeline just yet. There is a fight obviously hopping around, you know, being called out by Jai Opetaia, you know. Obviously respectfully, he's a good fighter and a good man. It's a fight that I would like to have too. Obviously maybe for the end of the year, build into a big fight, which I think it deserves to be. And two best cruiserweights in Australia, you know, banging it out to see who really is number one, and then they can move forward with their careers, you know. I've been around for about 9-10 years as a pro, so I've done all the hard stuff. I've established myself. I still work a full-time job and train, you know what I mean? So I'm still doing it the hard way, you know. I'm not looked after like a lot of fighters. I've got sponsors, you know, but I've got bills to pay. I've got a family on the way, so. Yeah, so I want the big fights, you know, and I work hard for them, you know. And like I said before, I don't fuck around when it comes to boxing. Yeah, I'm not here to play games, so any fight that makes sense to me, I'm going to take.
So if people wanted to find you on social media, have you got any websites that they can look for you on?
Yeah, obviously I've got Facebook, just Mark Bam Bam Flanagan. Same as my Instagram, it's just Mark Bam Bam Flanagan, all one word. And you can follow me on there and
Twitter as well.
Hey,
Twitter as well.
No, Twitter not yet. No, not that big in the social media just yet. But you want to follow me there and show your support. And obviously I've got some big fights coming up, hopefully in the pipeline, and not a world title shot. Hopefully next year if I can make it happen. Obviously big fights coming up, they've got to get through first, and then obviously we look forward to the future.
Brilliant. Well, thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much for having me.